If Allah tells you to go, then you go. That's fine. Allah will take care of me. But Ibrahim alayhi salam, before he left, he made a dua. قال رب إني أسكنت من ذريتي بواد غير ذي زرع عند بيتك المحرم ربنا ليقيموا الصلاة. Oh, the meaning of opening of the ayah, oh Allah. Oh Allah, I have left. I have house and left in this area that has no plants, basically no greens, no water. And your holy house or place, Kaaba, I left my offspring, dhurriyati, my wife and my kids. رَبَّنَا لِيُقِيمُ الصَّلَاةِ Oh Allah, so they can establish the prayers. Number one, the إِقَامَةُ الصَّلَاةِ. And then what happened after that? Because I'm leaving. رَبَّنَا فَجْعَلْ أَفْئِدَةً مِنَ النَّاسِ تَهْوِي إِلَيْكَ. The meaning of the ayah, Oh Allah, then make tahwi means fall. Like if you have something on top of a mountain and it goes, all of a sudden it falls down to the bottom, says hawa. Like a najm, one najmi ida, hawa. Like falls down sharply, steeply, from a very long place or a very high place. And it's a tashbih wa balagha, and what? That it is, the gravity is very high because it's a long place and it's just pulling it down. Ibrahim said, Oh Allah, فَجْعَلَ فِتَةً مِنَ النَّاسِ تَهْوِي إِلَيْهِمْ. Oh Allah, I'm leaving them behind, which means, so make some hearts of the people, the hearts of the people, what? Fall to them, like that. So your hearts, what? Would love them, so people can care for them, you see? So, again, Oh Allah, the Rabb meaning, I'm leaving from my offspring of who? Of Ibrahim alayhi salam. I'm leaving them in your house, around your house, where there is nothing. Oh Allah, so they establish the prayer, and Oh Allah, what? Make the hearts of people fall towards them. Go towards them. Inshallah, we will continue this, but let me just deduce something real quick because we have to finish. And we say that the best of the offspring of Ibrahim alayhi salam, who? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulullah is the best of offspring of Ibrahim. Therefore, the ulama and the scholars said what? They said that فَجْعَلْ أَفْئِدَةً مِنَ النَّاسِ تَهْوِي إِلَيْهِمْ. Make the hearts of people fall for them and love them. It's actually the one who is meant after Ismail is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because he's from the offspring of Ibrahim alayhi salam. Therefore, anyone who has the heart of muttaqi and has the heart of a believer, his heart will what? Will fall for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. No doubt. Therefore, you love them. You have to. Not only you have to, but you have to and you should. Therefore, Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu, Abu Hafs, Khalifa Rasulullah, comes to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and said, Ya Rasulullah, I love you like myself. That's not going to do, that's not going to cut it. I love you more than I love myself. He said, Ya Umar, you will not be a complete woman until you love me more than you love yourself that is between your hands and between your boundaries, basically. He said, Ya Rasulullah, Allah, but of course, the mustalah, the terminology we say, to the humans, salah means what? Means worshipping the Creator. When you say salah, Allahu Akbar, you are worshipping who? The Creator. As-salah min al-malaika. When the angels do salah, they're making istighfar for you. Imagine if Jibreel alayhi salam is saying, Oh Allah, forgive this person. Oh Allah, forgive this person. Oh Allah, see, istighfar al-malaika. Wa min Allah, as-salam ya rahma. And from Allah, as-salah, if Allah makes salam, you means what? Means Allah gives you His mercies and His bounties and forgives you. So as-salam ya Allah, al-rahma wal-maghfira. Mercy and forgiveness. And from the malaika, from the angels, is making istighfar for you. And from the slave or from the worshipper is what? Is making worshipping. Doing the act of worship. So, إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ. Allah is what? Is invoking His mercies and his blessings on the Prophet ﷺ. And the angels are also, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا all you who believe, صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ, make salah on him, وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا, and make salah on him. صلى الله عليه وسلم. الحمد لله كما ينبغي لجلاله وكماله والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وآله. When we say this is an order, this is a command, صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما, does the Prophet need our salah? Does the Prophet need every one of you to say, oh Allah, invoke your blessings, meaning of the salah? When you say Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala Sayyidina Muhammad, means, oh Allah, invoke your blessings, invoke your mercies, raise the rank of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his descendants. That's what it means, basically. But does the Prophet need that? No. Allah forgave everything, and he is the best of the creation. Does Allah need you to pray on the and say salam the Prophet and salam the Prophet? No. Allah is the creator, he's not in need of anything, and everything is in need of him. Then what is it? It is for us. It is for you. Remember the matter of business? You invest a little and you get a lot? This is what it is. You say, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala ali Sayyidina Muhammad, and Allah gives you so much. As-Sahaba radiallahu anhu, fima khajwa Imam Bukhari. Imam Bukhari and Nasa'i and others, and Sahih, and this hadith is very famous. They came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, Ya Rasulullah, qad alimna kayfa nusallimu alayk. We know how to say salamu alayk. But how do we say salat? كيف نصلي عليك؟ في البخاري الحديث. How do we make salah on you? And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, before that, the Prophet didn't say anything. And the Sahaba said, we wished we hadn't asked him because he was silent for a little bit. And then he said, الله قولوا اللهم صلي على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. So now you know how are you supposed to say اللهم صل على رسول الله وعلى آله وسلم. This is how the Prophet tells you that in Jibreel. Now, the last thing before we finish, then what is the benefit of this? Because we want to do something, we want to always get so much in return for it. Of course, number one, you know, حَسَنَ بِعَشَرِ أَمْثَالِهَا. You do one thing, you get multiplied by 10 in Islam immediately. Number two, a man came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and said, Ya Rasulullah, from my dua, when I have things to do, how much of that should I make, making salat and salam on you? One quarter of it? He said, that's good. And if you increase it, it's even better. He said, Ya Rasulullah, should I make half of my dua? Salam and salam on you. He said, that's good. And if you increase, it's better. And then the man said, Ya Rasulullah, should I make all my dua salam and salam on you? He said, إِذَنْ تُكْفَى هَمَّكَ وَغَمَّكَ. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take care of you and will take away all your worries and all your concerns. And therefore, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فِي مَخْرَجِ الْمَامِ الْتِرْمِدِي فِي سُنَنِهِ وَهُوَ حَدِيثٌ حَسَنٌ صَحِيحٌ, said, and Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ أَقْرَبَكُمْ مِنِي مَجْلِسًا يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَكْثَرُكُمْ صَلَاةً عَلَيْهِ. Those of you closest to me in the Day of Judgment, the Prophet is saying now, are those who say salat and salam on me most in the dunya. And if you say اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد, one time Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make salat, which means will forgive you and will bless you 10 more times, will wipe out 10 mistakes, will give you 10 hasanat, and will raise your rank in paradise 10 grades. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala ali Sayyidina Muhammad, kama sallaita ala Sayyidina Ibrahim wa ala ali Sayyidina Ibrahim, wa barak ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad, kama barakta ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim fil alamin innaka hamidun majid. اللهم انصر الاسلام والمسلمين واعلي يا مولانا كلمه الحق والدين. اللهم من اراد بالاسلام والمسلمين خيرا فوفقه اليه, ومن اراد بهم غير ذلك فاجعل دائره السوء عليه. اللهم رد المسلمين الى دينك ردا جميلا. اللهم ات انفسنا تقواها وزكها, انت خير من زكاها, انت وليها ومولاها. اللهم اشف مرضانا وعاف مبتلانا وفك اسرانا وارحم موتانا واغفر اللهم لنا ولابائنا ولمشايخنا ولمن له حقا علينا ولمن على الخير أعاننا ولمن عن الشر أبعدنا ولمن أوصانا بالدعاء وصلى الله وسلم على محمد وآله وأقم الصلاة.